Hello, everybody. Welcome to One Night in Paris. Just wanted to make a couple quick announcements. On Monday, we have our next vintage film, Sunset Boulevard. And coming up on the 14th, we have the Sonoma Conservatory of Dance doing Appalachian Cinderella. And at the end of the month, April 28th and 29th, we have an amazing, magical spectacular with dance and music, new illusions. It's Dr. R.K. Roten's magic show, magical medicine show, sorry about that. And there's new illusions, singing, dancing, choreography, all kinds of amazing things. So I hope you guys will all come check that out. And on with the show.
There is a fifth dimension beyond that which is known to man. It is a dimension as vast as space and as timeless as infinity. It is the middle ground between light and shadow, between science and superstition, and it lies between the pit of man's fears and the summit of his knowledge. This is the dimension of imagination. It is an area which we call the Twilight Zone.
Traveling through another dimension, a dimension not only of sight and sound, but of mind, a journey into a wondrous land whose boundaries are that of imagination. That's the signpost up ahead. Your next stop, the Twilight Zone.
Bonsoir et bienvenue à Paris. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Paris. I'm sure you are wondering who I am. Strangers and visitors call me the spirit of Paris, but Parisian people know this is not really true. My name is La Lune. Oops, sorry. The moon. Yes, I'm the moon. And I can see from here my reflection on the thousands of roofs of Paris. I love it! Bienvenue for this musical trip to the past and on the way to Paris's soul. Let's do a great feast following the sounds of the guitars, the accordions, and the violin. I remember what Ernest Hemingway said about the City of Light. He said something like this: Paris was a very old town, and we were young, and nothing was simple, even poverty, or the sudden richness, the moonlight, the good, the evil, or the breath of being asleep by your side in the moonlight. Paris was always worth it, and you always received something in return for what you gave it. This was the Paris of our youth. At the time when we were very poor and very happy. There is never an end to Paris, and the memory that all those who live there kept is different from one person to another. If you are lucky enough to have lived in Paris as a young man or a young woman, then wherever you go for the rest of your life, it stays with you, because Paris is a movable feast. Oh, how I love Ernest Hemingway's book. And now, ladies and gentlemen, let's discover the sound of Paris. Music, maestro!
En haut de la rue Saint-Vincent, un poète et une inconnue s'aimèrent l'espace d'un instant, mais il ne l'a jamais revue. Cette chanson il composa, espérant que son inconnue un matin de printemps l'entendra quelque part au coin d'une rue.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We are late, but now we are here. How are you doing? How is Sonoma doing? Good. How do you feel to be in Paris right now? The cheapest plane ticket. Ali, I want to sing a song for you because I love you very much. It's called Un jour tu verras. One day you will see, we will meet together. Un jour tu verras, on se rencontrera quelque part, n'importe où, guidé par le hasard. Regarderons et nous nous sourirons, et la main dans la main,
par les rues nous irons. Le temps passe si vite, la nuit cachera bien nos caresses de voleurs qui gardent leur bonheur. Puis nous arriverons sur une place grise où les pavés seront doux à nos âmes grises. Il y aura un bal très pauvre et très banal sous un ciel plein de brume et de mélancolie. Un aveugle joueur de l'orgue de barbarie, cet air pour nous sera le plus beau, le plus joli.
Under the Mirabeau Bridge flows the Seine, and our love. Shall I remember how joy always followed grief?
Vienne la nuit, sonne l'heure, les jours s'en vont, je demeure.
Come the night, toll the hour, days go by, still I remain.
Les mains dans les mains restons face à face, tandis que sous le pont de nos bras passent des éternels regards. L'onde Silas.
Holding hands, let's stay face to face as under the bridge of our arms flows the exhausted stream of everlasting stairs.
L'amour s'en va comme cette eau courante. L'amour s'en va comme la vie est lente et comme l'espérance est violente.
Love goes away like this flowing water. Love goes away. Life is so slow. And hope so fierce.
Passe les jours et passe les semaines, ni temps passé, ni les amours reviennent. Sous le pont Mirabeau coule la Seine.
No matter how many days and weeks go by, neither does past, nor love come back. Under the Mirabeau Bridge flows the Seine.
Vienne la nuit, sonne l'heure, les jours s'en vont, je demeure.
Come the night. Toll the hour. Days go by. Still, I remain.
Thank you.
you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much. Thank you for being here in Paris. Right? I feel the excitement in the room. Thank you so much. I hope the journey has been sweet on you. You're not too jet-lagged, and you're very well hydrated. If not, we'll have an intermission, and you can go to the bar. It's a really, really great pleasure to be playing for you tonight. We opened with a lot of very famous French songs. The last one was called Under Paris Skies. Very fitting for the evening. We're going to go on with a song that is really reminiscent of the 1900s, La Belle Époque in Paris, right where you are right now in this fifth dimension. La Belle Époque in Paris, street singers at the corners belting out their songs about love, and this is one of them. It's called La Goualante du Pauvre Jean. And if there are any French people in the room tonight, I would very much encourage them to sing along On n'est rien du tout at the end of each verse. If not, just fake it. You know, that sounds French enough. To welcome to the stage Michel Saga, the great bohemian. Where are you hiding? Hello. Now you're late.
How is your trip to Paris, ladies and gentlemen? This flies a non-smoking fly. So the songs we want to sing right now is a song from Charles Trenet. I love Charles Trenet because I am from Narbonne, southwest. And Charles Trenet, this genius of the French music, was from Narbonne. I remember when I was a little boy, I saw him each time when I go to the school on my bus, because we have no yellow bus, but we have a bus to go to school. At this time, we have electricity in France, yes. And so I remember Charles. And so the song we want to sing now with Isabelle and with Dave on the accordion is called Que reste-t-il de nos amours? Maestro. Olé. Ce soir, le vent qui frappe à ma porte me parle des amours mortes. Devant le vent qui s'éteint, ce soir, c'est une chanson d'automne dans la maison qui frissonne. Je repense aux jours lointains. Que reste-t-il de nos amours? Que reste-t-il de ces beaux jours? Une photo, vieille photo de ma jeunesse.
Que reste-t-il des billets doux, des mois d'avril, des rendez-vous, un souvenir qui me poursuit? Sans cesse.
Bonheur fané, cheveux au vent, baisers volés, rêves mouvants. Que reste-t-il de tout cela? Dites-le-moi.
Un petit village, un vieux clocher, un paysage si bien caché, et dans un nuage le cher visage de mon passé. Un paysage si bien caché, et dans un nuage, le cher visage de mon passé. Un petit village, un vieux clocher, un paysage si bien caché, et dans un nuage, le cher visage de mon passé.
Thank you very much. We welcome back to the stage the full band. And this time, there is no excuse. You are going to sing in French with us. We have a few words that we would really want you to sing with us. Are you okay with that? Yeah. Can you sing in French with us? Oui! Thank you, thank you, thank you. The first word is very short, it's si. The second word is also short, it's bon.
Whoa, you're brilliant.
They're very sharp, right? Yeah, yeah. Okay, put them together. Whoa. Now repeat them twice. Oh my God,
oh my
you
God.
Guys are too good.
You're good on mathematics.
Now I think you've seen this show before, right? There must be a reason for it. So here's a song that you might be familiar with because Louis Armstrong had an English version of it. He was in the south of France for a very famous jazz festival.
Yes.
Jazz à Antibes.
Yeah, I was there. It was great.
He was there. You were everywhere. You're everywhere. And he heard the song and he said, well, let me see. Oh, that's a really good song. No, that's a really very bad
great
very
imitation.
Bad. Yeah, no, that's a very bad imitation of Louis Armstrong. Anyway, he thought it was a really good song and he thought it'd bring it back to America and have a. So he had a great success with it, with, of course, slightly different lyrics than the original lyrics. Which, by the way, so you can, you know, impress your friends. They were written by somebody who was looking at the lingerie window.
Wow.
That's how this song came about.
I didn't know
that. The composer was walking down the street in Nice. He happened to see a lingerie window, and he thought, rushed home, wrote it down, and it's a hit. Here we go.
This is an adult show tonight.
Yeah, I know. C'est si bon,
si bon, si bon,
de partir n'importe où.
Si bon, si bon,
bras dessus, bras dessous.
Si bon, si bon,
en chantant des chansons. C'est si bon,
si bon, si bon,
de se dire des mots doux.
Si bon, si bon,
des petits rien du tout.
Si bon, si bon,
mais qui en disent long en voyant notre mine à vie. Les passants dans la rue nous envient. C'est si bon,
si bon, si bon,
de guetter dans ses yeux.
Si bon, si bon,
cet espoir merveilleux.
Si bon, si bon,
qui me donne le frisson. C'est si bon, ces petites sensations. Ça vaut mieux qu'un million. Tellement, tellement c'est bon.
Thank you.
mais qui en disent long. But I need to tell you about what's coming. This is a song that you all know, and I'm sure you've heard it. Maybe Frank Sinatra's version is your version, I don't know. But you've heard it before, I'm sure. It was kind of his signature song. And tonight, to sing this song, which was originally written in French, people, I kid you not, written in French, and made popular in the 60s by a guy, Google him if you have time to spare. Claude François. He had two first names. Claude François. He was a big star in the 60s in France. And he had a huge hit with the following song. And to give us a song tonight, we have one of the best, if not the best, Mr. Dave Majorki.
Thank you, everybody. And now the end is near. And so I face the final curtain. My friend, I'll say it clear. I'll state my case, of which I'm certain. I've lived a life that's full. I've traveled each and every highway. But more, much more than this, I did it my way. Regrets, I've had a few, and then again too few to mention. I did what I had to do and saw it through without exemption. I planned each charted course, each careful step along the byway. But more, much more than this, I did it my way. Yes, there were times, I'm sure you knew, when I bit off more than I could chew. But through it all, when there was doubt, I ate it up and spit it out. I did it all. And I stood tall and did it my way. I loved, I laughed, I cried. I had my fill, my share of losing. And now his tears subside. I find it all so amusing to think I did all that. And may I say, not in a shy way, oh no, not me, I did it my way. For what is a man, what has he got? If not himself, then he has not to say the things he truly feels, and not the words of one who kneels. The record shows I took the blows and did it my way.
Didn't I tell you? You didn't expect that, did you? All right. Well, this next song doesn't need any introduction, except that it was written by Edith Piaf herself, who actually wrote it for a friend of hers who needed a song. And so they got together at a coffee table someday in Paris, and Edith Piaf had that song in her head, and she started writing it for her friend. And pretty soon she had to record it herself. But the problem, she couldn't sign it in her own name because she didn't pass the test for the Composers Society in France. So she couldn't get the royalties. She had to ask a friend to sign the music for her because she didn't pass the test. And so she went around, and she asked people in her team of songwriters, hey, would you sign the music for the song? And they said, nah, this is not a good song. You should forget about it. And finally, one guy said, yeah, I'll sign it for you. And I don't think he regretted it one day of his life. Les yeux qui font baisser les miens, un rire qui se perd sur sa bouche. Voilà le portrait sans retouche de l'homme auquel j'appartiens. Quand il me prend dans ses bras, il me parle de tout bas. Je vois la vie en rose. Quelque chose. Il est entré dans mon cœur une part de bonheur dont je connais la cause. C'est lui pour moi, moi pour lui dans la vie. Il me l'a dit, la jure pour la vie. Et dès que je l'aperçois, alors je sens Greatest bohemian of them all, the greatest gypsy of them all, the one who was born in 1910 by the border of Belgium in a small gypsy caravan, and then was raised along the roads of France and became an international star, the great father of the gypsy jazz, the creator of gypsy jazz. And I want to say, of course, maybe you know your name. His name is Django Reinhardt. Django Reinhardt in the 1920s and 30s heard jazz coming from America. Jazz played by Louis Armstrong, Duke Ellington, the great jazz bands and the great jazz artists coming from America and played on records back in Paris. He heard them and he wanted to be them. But he had only guitars, violin, upright bass. He didn't have any of the classical jazz instruments like trumpets or saxophones or drums or pianos or whatever you can think of as jazz instruments. He only had string instruments. And so he thought, this is not a big deal. I can play jazz on any kind of instrument. And that's what he did. He adapted jazz to string ensemble, and this is what we have for you here today. And the greatest gypsy jazz player is him, this guy, Mr. Paul Mehling. He's gonna play Django Reinhardt's Minus One.
Thank you.
Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. We're going to take a short break. This is the intermission. This is the part where you can get rehydrated. See you soon.
Great. So the crew closed the door. So mask, come on your face, case. No, I'm sorry. My dear Isabelle, let's start with the ghost of Edith Piaf. Arrêtez.
Isabelle Fontaine, ladies and gentlemen.
Hello again. It's the moon. I've just returned to share with you all some quotes I really like. Being Parisian is not being born in Paris. It's being reborn. Sacha Guitry. Paris is the only city in the world where starving is still considered an art. Carlos Ruiz Zafón. The real Parisian does not like Paris, but he cannot live elsewhere. Alphonse Carr. In Paris, everyone wants to be an actor. No one is resigned to be a spectator. Jean Cocteau. Paris is very small for those who love each other with such great love. Jacques Prévert. When I come to Paris, it seems to me that I enter an insane asylum where the guardians themselves would be insane. André Billy. There is, between London and Paris, this difference that Paris is made for the foreigner and London for the English. England built London for its own use. France built Paris for the whole world. Ralph Waldo Emerson. In New York, the taxis are yellow. In London, they are black. And in Paris, they are unpleasant. My father. Music maestro!
I love the moon. She's my best friend.
Nous sommes allongés sur l'herbe de l'été. Il est tard, on entend chanter des amoureux et des oiseaux. On entend chuchoter le vent dans la campagne. On entend chanter la montagne. Ses yeux dans le ciel, que ce ciel dans tes yeux, que ta main qui joue avec ma main. Que ta main qui joue avec ma main.
It was a Charles Trenet song again because I'm a big fan of Charles Trenet. And the next song is a crooner song. This is why I want to sing this song. I always dream to be a crooner like you, Polo.
Bah oui.
Bah oui. You are my master on crooner game.
Mais non, mais non.
Mais oui, mais oui. Mais non, mais non. Oh, et quel bassiste! Did you recognize him, ladies and gentlemen? Take your mask out. He's the godfather of the gypsy jazz right. in America, Mr. Paul Melly. Maestro.
J'avais 15 ans, c'était le temps de ma première guitare. Et tout ce temps revient souvent du fond de ma mémoire. Ces 15 ans-là, c'était Django qui les mettait en fête. En ce temps-là, c'était Django que j'avais dans la tête. Dans sa musique, il y avait comme une odeur de feu de bois. Il y avait un je ne sais quoi, moitié Bohème, moitié Harlem. Et surtout ça, assez joyeux, de merveilleux nuages, pareil à ceux qu'ont dans les yeux tous les gens du voyage. De changer de guitare. Et le gitan de mes 15 ans est là dans ma mémoire. Et bien des fois, c'est malgré moi, il me vient quelques notes, comme un refrain venu soudain du fond d'une roulotte. Alors je sens sous mes doigts monter l'odeur du feu de bois. J'entends comme un je ne sais quoi, moitié Harlem, moitié Bohème. Et sur ton cœur passe joyeux ces merveilleux nuages, pareil à ceux qu'ont dans les yeux tous les jours du voyage.
Merci beaucoup, ladies and gentlemen. Isabelle, Jeff and Paul. He sounds a little bit like the Beatles. Isabelle, Jeff and Paul.
And Django.
I am Ringo. I am the Lord now. The Queen, she give me a special thing here. The Queen of England, not the Queen of America, of course. Bye-bye.
Michel Saga. And now, a special treat. We have the dobro guitar. We're going to play for you a song written by Jacques Brel. Any of you remember who Jacques Brel is? Oh, yes. These are really big shoes to fill.
Thank you. plus parler, je me cacherai là à te regarder danser, sourire et à t'écouter chanter et puis rire. Laisse-moi devenir l'ombre de ton ombre, l'ombre de ta main, l'ombre de ton chien. Ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas, ne me quitte pas.
We welcome back to the stage, David Majotki.
Thank you. Every time I look down on that timeless town, whether gray or blue be her skies, whether bright be her cheer, whether sad be her tear, more and more do I realize that I love Paris in the springtime. I love Paris in the fall. I love Paris in the winter when it drizzles. I love Paris in the summer when it sizzles. I love Paris every moment, every moment of the year.
This one is probably the most famous jazz song written in French ever. It's being taught in every jazz school, and it really is. It's our pleasure to play it for you tonight because the rights of this song, the publishing rights, actually belong to Sir Paul McCartney, and we really want him to be richer. Even more comfortable than he is right now. Everything we can do for Mr. Sir Paul McCartney, we will. Here it is. Oh, j'aimerais tant que tu te souviennes des jours heureux où nous étions amis. En ce temps-là,
the autumn leaves.
Welcome back to the stage, Michel Saga. Come on, Michel, come on here. Tell us about this this place in Paris that you know so well.
Oh, yeah, I love this place in Paris called Ménilmontant. It's on the northeast. You see where is the Bastille, the Nation? Okay, cool.
Have you ever been demonstrating in France? Because that's the route, you know, you go from the Bastille to Nation and maybe a Republique. That's where all the strikes people go.
Yeah. And now they have also an extra trick. They block all the train. Vive la France! So Ménilmontant is on the north, on the east, on the north, on the east of Paris. And it's the place where Maurice Chevalier, Bola, Momo. We love Momo, Maurice Chevalier. So Ménilmontant was a song written not by Maurice Chevalier, but by Charles Trenet. And it's a tribute to Les Gars de Ménilmontant, the little boy of Ménilmuche, we call that. And it's a tribute to Maurice Chevalier, too. I love it. Maestro. C'est là que j'ai laissé ma vie. C'est là que je viens retrouver mon âme, toute ma flamme, tout mon bonheur. Quand je revois ma petite église où les mariages allaient gaiement, quand je revois ma vieille maison grise où même la brise parle tantôt, elle me raconte comme autrefois de jolis contes. Au jour passé, je vous revois rendez-vous. Une musique, des yeux rêveurs, les tiens, Isa. Tout un roman d'amour poétique et pathétique. Ménilmontant. Thank you.
C'est là que je viens retrouver mon âme, toute ma flamme, tout mon bonheur. Quand je revois ma petite gare, où chaque train passait joyeux, j'entends encore dans le tintamarre des mots bizarres, des mots d'adieu. Je suis pas poète, mais je suis ému. Et dans ma tête, y a des souvenirs jamais perdus. Un soir d'hiver, une musique, des yeux très doux, les tiens bizarres. Tout un roman d'amour poétique et pathétique, mais ni le montant.
Bravo. I'm proud of them. They play as I teach them.
We have recorded in January, and the CD is not out yet, so unfortunately you can't purchase that one tonight, but we still have a lot of CDs out there in the lobby, and if you want to have a little souvenir from Paris, you know what to do. Anyway, this one, again, doesn't need any introduction. You've all heard it before. Maybe not that way, though. C'est payé.
Je n'ai plus besoin de balayer mes amours avec leur très bon nom. Balayer pour toujours, je repars à zéro. Je ne regrette rien.
Merci. C'est une grande première en public, hein, je peux vous le dire. Oh yeah, you have no idea what I just said. I said, this is the first time we performed it in front of an audience, so thank you so much. It's brand new. Yes. This one we've done many, many times. It's, again, one of Edith Piaf's. She's incontournable, whatever that is in English. What?
Pasta.
Pasta?
Yeah.
Okay, whatever. this one, actually, there's a backstory to it. Usually Jeff tells it on, but he doesn't have a mic, so I'm gonna... You wanna tell the story, Jeff?
Now I kinda have to, don't I?
Yes, you do.
My wife, my loving wife here, you can applaud her, by the way, yeah. I know. Lucky guy, huh? But she lets me introduce this one because it's kind of sexy. So it takes place in South America. It's hot. It's kind of hot in here. It's hotter there, though. It's hot and people are sweating. People are half-dressed. People are singing and drinking in a small village. It is hot. It is swelty.
How hot is it, Jeff?
It is so hot that this woman walks into the village and is just taken up in the festival and finds herself singing and drinking and dancing. She doesn't even, before, she barely knows what happens to her in there. She finds herself in a crowd of people, thrust up against this handsome man. And it is love at first sight, folks, right there. It happens. It is. And it was. And they did. Sorry, Andy Griffith kind of sneaks in sometimes. I can't help it. It's an old age thing. As I was saying, it was hot down there. These people were sweating, and this couple find themselves thrust up against one another, and they looked into each other's eyes, and there was love. But just as they had been thrust together, so did the crowd pull them apart, never to see each other again. That is our tale of woe. This is a song that Edith Piaf actually adapted by, it's written by two Peruvian, they have family here. And believe it or not, that's kind of a sad song, but the original version is even worse than that. It's so sad, I'm not even gonna tell you what it is. We're just gonna play it for you.
Thank you, Jeff. Thank you.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. It's been a real pleasure to play for you tonight. And I would like to introduce all the musicians who have been on the stage with us. Mr. Dave Majotki on the accordion. And vocals, of course. Jeff Magidson on the guitar and the bass. Evan Price on the violin. Paul Mailing on bass and guitar. Michel Saga, somewhere here. Come on, Michel. Come on. And also, we would like to
And let me introduce you to the singer, the maestro, the diva. We love her, we share her with Jeff, but he doesn't want to say that to you, but it's true. We love her and her voice, Isabelle Fontaine. Bravo!
Thank you. Also, the technicians who have made this possible. We had Tony Ginesi, light and sound. We would like to thank the voice of the moon who introduced the show for us tonight. Her name is Luna Michelis from Cirque de Bohème. Hosted crew was Mary Catherine Cutliffe. And a very special thank to Erika Schmidt from MM Production Administration. This has been One Night in Paris.
Thank you very much, everybody. Thank you. Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, one more time for this incredible band, incredible musician, Isabel, Jeff, Dave, Paul, and Evan. I am a lucky producer. I am really, really lucky to work with musicians like that. It's just a pleasure for me. It's a pleasure to produce some show here in Sonoma with the quality of these musicians. And I'm also a lucky producer with the Cirque de Bohème and all these circus artists coming from all over America just for your pleasure here in Sonoma every winter. Thank you very much for your support. Without you, we are nothing. Thank you very much. And I hope to see you again for a new production. It was One Night in Paris. Thank you. Thank you.